Here we are at the Bemberg Foundation in Toulouse in front of a piece of art painted by the famous painter Claude Monet. To create a piece like this, of which the coloured harmony still amazes us, it was necessary for him to turn to the use of an instrument essential for every painter but which he used with a talent unique to art history. His secret, the palette. The palette made of walnut, apple tree, porcelain, metal and sometimes even crystal replaces the jars of colour used since painting was invented. From the beginning of the Renaissance, we used a palette with colours necessary to carry out a day's work, prepared daily by the workshop apprentices. With few colours, these painters succeeded in creating advanced coloured harmonies. From the 18th century, the chemical industry, then rapidly expanding, supplied numerous and new colours every year. The painters made these colours their own and largely widened their palette to receive them, like Delacroix, a painter of the 19th century, who could have up to 45 different colours on one immense palette. Claude Monet leaves aside classic colours, such as red ochre, yellow ochre, castle earth, malachite green, earth green, and even Naples yellow. He prefers new and bright tints and organizes his palette to suit, firstly silver white, yellow cadmium, some vermilion, garance, cobalt blue, emerald green. He also adds clear purple cobalt, blue ultramarine, and some cadmium orange. As he ages, Claude Monet is affected by cataracts. He is then operated on one eye, and the result is clearly visible on certain series of paintings. From the 1920s on, the artist paints either with his weak eye and a palette full of hot red tones, or with the operated eye and a palette filled with blue tones. The last masterpieces of this remarkable painter will be created with a long-lived memory of colours that have followed him all his life.